program on how to use natural remedies and the Bible to reach people. So we're just thankful for their willingness to come to help us here and to teach us. And they've got all kinds of amazing things in store for us, as you can see. So I hope some of you are willing to be guinea pigs, because they need some. But I'd like us to start with a word of prayer, if that's okay, and then we'll begin. Our precious Heavenly Father, we thank you so much for simple things that you have created for our health. And Lord, I just pray that you will be with us and bless us and teach us. And we thank you in Jesus' name, amen.
Amen.
So I'm going to let them introduce themselves to you because I don't know all their names yet. And we'll turn the time over to them.
Demonstrating some hydrotherapy treatments, but before we do, what is hydrotherapy? Hydrotherapy is made up of two words, hydro, meaning water, and therapy, meaning treatment. The definition of hydrotherapy is the external use of water and medical treatments to treat certain medical diseases and injuries. We use water in its three forms, solid, liquid, and vapor. Want me to start over?
No, I heard you.
Okay.
I did what I heard. Yeah.
Okay. Water is very valuable. It's cheap. It's usually always available. It's very abundant. It's easy to apply, and it's not an irritant, inside and out. Hydrotherapy is used for circulation, increasing circulation in the body. It's good for moving blood from one part of the body to another part of the body. It's also good for relieving pains and aches. And we do this by using hot and cold water. So JC's going to explain how we use the hot and cold water and what it does to the body.
So, like before, my name is JC, and I'm going to tell you the differences between using hot and cold water for the treatments, besides temperature, of course. Using heat for hydrotherapy is really beneficial in many different ways, such as increasing your blood flow. It's really good for circulation throughout the body, and it's good for an inflammatory response. So if you have swelling in your leg or arm or something, that could help with the swelling a lot. It can decrease it pretty quickly. It increases hemorrhage, and it decreases muscle pain and spasms, of course. And it also decreases stiffness with arthritis or any kind of stiffness, really. Now, the cold water also helps as well. You may think, cold water, it shouldn't help, but it does in a lot of ways. It actually decreases the blood flow. It decreases inflammatory response. So we usually, with hydrotherapy, we usually end our treatments with cold water to get the blood rushing back to the rest of the body instead of the one area. It decreases muscle pain and spasm, so when you hurt something or pull the muscle, it really helps with the swelling, and it also increases stiffness, so it might not be good for arthritis.
So now the first treatment we will be demonstrating is the hot footbath, and that will be demonstrated by Emily.
Can you wait just a second? We're having problems. We have a bunch of people who can't be here that want to.
Good evening, ladies.
Good evening.
Thank you for being here today.
So would one of you like to be a part of the demonstration for the hot foot bath treatment? It will involve your feet and ankles and being placed into the hot water tub here. If anybody would like, that'd be lovely. Lovely. Yeah. Thank you. I can cover that, sorry. So yeah, lovely. So the procedure will involve you sitting here on this chair. And I'm going to be covering you with a sheet and a blanket. Thank you, yeah, wonderful. If you could, would it be possible to take off these tights or socks? So as we just heard, the hot water dilates the blood vessels, and this occurs in the feet, and this draws the blood that has become congested in other parts of the body. It enables the blood to flow to the feet, which can decongest the brain and other internal organs. For instance, that is related to headache. You know, when you have congestion here. So it can be a very good form of headache relief. And it's a good treatment for around 15 or 20 minutes. Lovely. So I'm hoping that this is the right temperature for you. Would you like to just test it with your wrist a moment, just to make sure? Your wrist is, yeah? Often the hands can withstand much higher heat than the feet, so it's always good to try with your wrist. Or your elbow. So, would you be able to have a little bit more hot? Wonderful. I could just give you the towel, thank you. So, when you're placed in the water, as it's quite hot, it's important, don't want to put my back to you, to have your hand as a shield between the hot water and the feet. And it's good to keep your feet in there so you can let me know whether the temperature is good. So I'll do it slowly. Is that good for you? Okay. You just let me know when it's comfortable for you. Good, so now if you place your feet there, it's good to have the feet and the ankles covered. I'll take this to you, thanks. And now I'm going to wrap the sheet and the blanket around you. I'm so sorry, what is your name? Sharon. Sorry, I didn't ask you. So I'm going to just place the sheet around Sharon. Make sure there isn't any draft coming through. So this is the first one.
The batteries are probably low.
And make sure the neck is nice and closed there, so no draft coming through. Right around the body and the bar. All covered. And now the blanket after. Yeah, it's lovely and warm. Sorry, this is making quite a lot of noise.
Maybe you may just have to turn that off. I don't know.
Sorry about that. Ensure that Sharon is warm, and just place this around hand here. Keep it closed. So, what I do is, you're sweating already, so now this is a good time to... Oh. Would you like to have some purple water on your forehead or not quite at the moment? Okay. So with this hot water bath, foot bath, sorry. Thank you. So the idea is to have this treatment going for about 15 to 20 minutes. And we will, throughout the treatment, as and when needed, be placing the cold flannel, which has been in water, icy water, to place that on Sharon's forehead to prevent her from becoming too hot. And we also have water on the side to ensure that she has continuous drinking, because with the sweating and this treatment, you can become dehydrated. And it's good to rest after this treatment, as advisable, and yeah, it can be a very good form of pain relief. It can be very good for decongestion, as in it can, the congestion in different parts of the body, whether it's the chest, it can help relieve that and decrease the decongestion in different areas of the body. It can also activate white blood cells too, so this can be a good prevention for colds and flus, and help someone get over the symptoms of such illnesses. So it's really a good treatment, and it's good if possible, if you have the time to do so, few treatments during the course of the day and for a few days. It can be a really wonderful treatment, and we have more information about it in our booklet there, so you can read more about it in your own time. And so yeah, this is wonderful. Just another 15 minutes. Would you like some water at the moment? Yeah, hopefully.
Someone who's running a fever and they're just shaking, complaining about being cold.
Yes, very good treatment.
It's very good. Yeah. Very good for fever, for headache, for sinus. You need
any ache, actually.
Yeah.
It helps even with toothache.
Yes, it helps with migraines. Yes.
Increases that blood flow.
Yeah. And because the water is so hot at the feet, you have to pull the congestion out of your head.
Yeah.
Here's your time.
Thank you.
She
wants more. Yes, sure.
My feet are getting cold.
Like a
salt. So, like I said, just making sure that my hand is between the feet and the hot water pouring to make sure that feet don't get burnt. Let me know when you're comfortable.
It's a high tolerance.
Thank you. Lovely. So now we'll have this treatment for a further 15 minutes. If that's all right with you. Lovely, Sharon. Thanks. Thank you.
She's ready.
So far, so now we're going to do the next step, and that is to pour some cold water upon Sharon's feet, and that would then be the end of this treatment. And like I said, it's good to be able to do this a few times a day if possible. So lovely.
And she's not a typical patient, because most people will be begging for the cola on the head.
Very true, yeah.
She's enjoying it.
Yeah, loving the warmth.
To get circulation going again, because now everything is in the feet kind of, and now we need to get it up again. So we kind of shake the feet up a little bit with the cold, and then it goes up again to the whole back.
Yeah, and I apologize, I wasn't meant to take the sheet and blanket off until I poured the water. Sorry, I made a mistake here.
Well, that's really a mistake. It's just the more fun. Like if she has would be wrapped still, and then she would pour the cold water, and then she will unwrap her, because it might feel too cold in one time, you know?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Are you feeling all right, Sharon?